Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware here. Today I'm going to show you how to get native Adobe Illustrator files right into Adobe InDesign or right into QuarkXPress. So we're not talking about a flattened image, you know, just placing a page, one image as a page or as an object. We're talking about actually converting the vector-based file, the Adobe Illustrator native file, with all elements right into InDesign or QuarkXPress. And we'll show you why and how that's useful for those that might be curious further. All right, first let me just give you a little bit of background. Markzware's PDF DTP is a tool, in this case for, I'll show you, an InDesign for CS6, CS5.5, or CS5, and it can also be used in QuarkXPress, QuarkXPress 9 right now. And the way that works is, in this case, in InDesign, you go via the Markzware menu item, you select PDF DTP, and you convert a PDF. And we'll just pick the brochure here from this very product. And, you know, just pretend now this PDF is all you have left. So this product is very useful because it'll allow you to open and use a file that otherwise would just be a static PDF. You probably have to recreate it or at best hack around in Acrobat to try to get it back into InDesign or QuarkXPress or some kind of desktop publishing environment you're familiar with. But look at that. With a click, Markzware's PDF DTP brings it right on over so you can actually take this and start, you know, moving objects around, changing text. You can actually edit text to be whatever you like. So it's quite cool. It's really amazing because a PDF format is quite chaotic internally. And I should mention, it's even extracting these images out and placing them in a job folder, which PDF DTP also creates for you. So very handy. Now, we got a customer request one day, well, how can I get my Illustrator files into QuarkXPress? Well, that's quite possible with PDF DTP. First of all, let me show you, let me open up a file in Adobe Illustrator here. And this file, a logo for the local soccer club here, has text on a line. And down here, looks like text, but of course these have been converted to outlines. So you can now resize at will. And you don't need these fonts if you're going to send it off to be printed or to somebody else, but it's locked in at that form, so that's the disadvantage. By the way, Markzware's flight check will collect an Illustrator file with all fonts and images included. Any version of CS, CS3, CS4, CS5, etc. This is just an example. Obviously, you can get much more complicated Illustrator files, although this is probably complicated enough. But you can get files with, you know, entire brochures and things like that. Now what I'm going to show you now is if I take this file and I copy it and I go over to Adobe InDesign and I make a new document and I paste this file in there that I just copied from Illustrator, you'll see I get it. So why do I need to import an Illustrator file into InDesign? So what you're going to get here is something that is, you know, perhaps useful, but look at, for instance, the, I want to get into that text there. I can't. This text is not editable. It's been converted effectively into outlines without asking you when you copy and paste it. So I can take that and I can, you know, do all kind of funky things, but that's not what I want. I want editable text I can work with, not objects I can simply, you know, resize and delete one by one. I want a block of text. So now let's go see how Markzware's PDF DTP would handle this same job. So we'll go up here to Markzware PDF DTP, convert PDF. And if I search for the Olivio logo there, we'll see here that same exact file. And now when I click open, and I've made a PDF to check it out, you know, of course that works as well. But if I just take the native Illustrator file and I click open, I'm not converting the Illustrator file right into InDesign. So not just copying it in, I'm actually getting the full Monty here. And what you'll see right away is that text on the line is there for me to edit at will. Lovely, isn't it? So this is very, very cool. Now, of course, these fonts down here will stay as outline because that's what they were in the original file. So that makes sense. Really neat. Now, some important little tips here. In Illustrator, what you need to do is make sure that when you're saving out the file, so I'll do a file save as, you know, you have everything just like that, you hit save, and then what you see here is options, create PDF compatible file. PDF DTP will convert that native Adobe Illustrator file when this is clicked on, which is by default, but this needs to be clicked on when you save your Illustrator file. If that's preserved, then you can open up these native Illustrator files right up within Adobe InDesign and benefit from that artwork you've created now within a familiar desktop publishing environment like Adobe InDesign. So this can be very handy to get in certain pieces of artwork directly from Illustrator right into InDesign or even QuarkXPress. All right, so here I am on my other machine with my QuarkXPress 9.3. I have the same file over here. I'll open that up in Illustrator. Now we're in CS6, QuarkXPress 9.3, all the latest versions. Kind of like that new splash screen. All right, so here we have the same exact logo in Illustrator. I select all, Command C to copy, and I switch on over into Quark where I create a new project. And I hit paste, and nothing happens. I can't even paste, but you can't. So it won't paste over, so that option's out of the question. Now, of course, I could create an EPS or a, you know, TIFF or whatever out of that native file and place it as an image, but then I can't edit the fonts and stuff as easily. So here's how you can, if you know, for a lot of people, they might only have Quark. They don't even have Illustrator, or at least not the latest version. So with Markzware's new PDF DTP and QuarkXPress, you can not only convert PDF files, but you can also convert the native Illustrator file. And here it is on our desktop, and I click open. And just like you saw on InDesign, it just sucks that right in, and plop, there you go. Full-on conversion. In a new Quark layout where I can now go in and edit text, make changes at will, and use this file in a QuarkXPress project. Once again, this is just a small example, a little logo from our local soccer club here in the Netherlands. However, imagine when you have a more complex file. This could be extremely useful. Illustrator to QuarkXPress with Markzware's PDF to DTP, and Illustrator to InDesign. Helicopter going overhead, close to the airport here, kind of fitting for Flight Check, our pre-flight product. In any event, this is the power of native conversion of .ai Adobe Illustrator files right into your familiar desktop publishing environment. Whether Adobe InDesign or QuarkXPress, we can get it right in there for you. If you need more information on Markzware's PDF DTP, cruise on over to markzware.com and to the PDF DTP page. So that's been the quick tip of the day from David here at Markzware. On behalf of everybody at Markzware, we invite you to come over and check out our products on markzware.com. Thank you. Signing on for now, David from Markzware.